First, let's look at the difference between a towboat and a tugboat. A lot of people mistakenly lump them into one category and call them tugboats, but they both have different uses. A tugboat has a pointed bow, and it is used to position larger ships generally by pulling them to a short-term destination. The term towboat is misleading, since these boats actually push their cargo with a square bow, or the front of the boat which can face up flush against the tow. The term tow refers to a grouping of barges that are actually being pushed by the towboat rather than pulling the load from behind. These towboats are mainly used on rivers and lakes, since they are flat-bottomed and therefore highly maneuverable. Fleet towboats are generally used in a localized area, and they have no sleeping quarters, since the crews go home at the end of the day after positioning barges for larger towboats. The larger towboats are often used on the inland river waterways and are generally called line haul boats. These towboats are used for more long-term assignments, pushing barges carrying different cargoes of steel, grain, fertilizer, and chemicals. They often go long distances, sometimes with crews living aboard the boats for up to 30 days at a time. A common barge size is 35 feet by 195 feet, with a cargo depth space of 14 feet. The power of a towboat can push a collection of 3 barges wide, a total of 105 feet wide, and typically 4 barges long, making the collective tow some 800 feet in length. That's over 2 football fields long. There are 3 types of barges. The covered hopper barge carries grains and dry bulk, fertilizer, salt, etc. A deck barge is a heavy plated barge with a deck to which cargo is tied down. You can move large equipment and machinery on this type of barge. A tank barge is used to transport liquids. Some carry petroleum products, while others carry liquid chemicals and other commodities like molasses. At the Tulsa Port of Catoosa, there is a smaller towboat on display. It is the Motor Vessel Charlie Border, named after a man who was very instrumental in developing the MCARNs and forming the Tulsa Port of Catoosa. We will refer to it to discuss the parts of a towboat. The front part of the boat is called the bow. The back of the boat is called the stern. The left side of the boat as you face the front is the port side. The right side of the boat is called the starboard side. The body of the boat, not including the motor and extras, is called the hull. The tow knees are located on the front of the bow. This is the contact point used to butt up against the barges and push the tow. The kevel is a metal cleat on the barge where wire cables are wrapped around it to secure barges to the towboat. A winch is used as a motorized way to tighten the barges against the tow knees on the towboat. Here, you will see that the propeller looks like a fan. It converts rotational motion and gives the towboat thrust to go forward or backward. Typically, engines running on diesel fuel power the propeller. The engines are 2 propulsion diesel engines that combine to produce 366 horsepower at 1,800 revolutions per minute. A third diesel engine is smaller and is used to run a generator which makes the electricity for lights, horn, winches, air compressor, and hydraulic steering system. The double bit or H-bit is located on the main deck at the front between the tow knees and also on the back of the deck. It is used to wrap the lines when tying the boat to the dock. Aft is referred to as the rearmost part of the vessel, but still on the inside, while the stern refers to the outside rearmost part of the vessel. The deck is the floor of the towboat that you stand on. And finally, the pilot house is where the ship is controlled by the captain. It is sometimes called the wheelhouse, and it is usually located on top of the largest or highest deck. The steering wheel, or helm, and other instrumentation is located here. The Charlie Border towboat was dedicated on February 20th, 1971, the same day as the dedication of the Tulsa Port of Catoosa. The original purchase price was about $71,000. And when it was taken out of service in 1998, the replacement boat cost more than $500,000. In 27 years of service, the MV Charlie Border switched over 23,334 barges, many of which were filled with cargo destined for the port's 12 barge terminals. Today, you can get an up-close look at this towboat as it is on display outside the Oklahoma Maritime Education Center, located in the John R. Stewart Maritime Park. As you can see, towboats are the backbone of moving cargo and barges in and around the port daily, as well as providing the means to move huge tows of barges up and down the waterways for hundreds of miles.